Hey everyone, today on 31 Days of Landing Page Design, I'm going to show you how to make a super simple newsletter landing page. I know it can be tempting to spend a ton of time building out the perfect landing page before you start attempting to build your newsletter audience, but I'm here to tell you that that's probably the wrong way to go about it. And that it's generally much better to just get something out there so you can start testing your idea before you spend a ton of time building it out. So today I'm going to show you how to make a very fast, effective newsletter signup page. Let's go. I'm building this page in AWeber, which is an easy to use, powerful tool for building out landing pages, sending newsletters, and building automated email sequences for your business or project. So I'm going to click create a landing page. And then I'm going to search over here for newsletter because I'm going to start with this very simple signup form. And I'm going to choose this template. So today I'm going to be building a landing page for a newsletter all about piano, learning how to play the piano. I love to play the piano. Part of me thinks that one day I will make this newsletter, but not today. Today I'm just going to show you how to do it. Now I'm going to start out by setting my base styles for the page. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just have a solid color background for this page because my goal is to get something done as quickly as possible that looks good and is clear and easy to use so I can start sharing it and seeing how many people are interested enough to sign up. So I'm going to eliminate everything that'll take me time to think about. So my color I'm going to use is like a blue for the background. So I'll click this color picker. Pick kind of like a mid-range blue because I'm going to want white text on it. Maybe I'll make it just a little darker. Cool. And now I'm going to set my font styles. So since this is such a dark background, I'm going to change my base color to white so it really pops. I'm going to fix this form in just a second, but that's looking pretty good. And I'm going to increase my font size up to 20 pixels. My base font size. Now, the last thing I want to do is add a little character to this page by changing my header font size and font family. Now, I'm going to use a serif font. So a sans serif is a font like this that has just kind of straight pipes and pieces to it. And a serif font has little extra things called serifs on the ends of some of the figures. I'll show you what that looks like. I'm going to use a font called Playfair. I think it's called Playfair. Yeah, Playfair Display. You see, this is a serif font. It looks a little bit more serious and ornamental. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to shrink the size of some of my headings. I'm going to pull my H1, which is the largest, most prominent heading on the page, down to, let's say, something pretty small. Maybe not 24, maybe I'll go 28. Then my H2, which is the heading in the form, I'm going to change that to 24. Boom, nice. Okay, now the last thing I need to do here is change the color of some of these, of the elements in the form container. I'm just going to set these to black. So I'll highlight that text, and I'll change it to black. Then I need to do the same thing with the labels here. So I'm going to click on the form and change the text color to black. There we go. Now, let me finish making some design changes here, and then I'm going to create a really quick logo. So I'm going to click on this row that has these two columns in it. I'm going to select the right-hand column, and I'm going to just change the background color to white. That looks good. And I'm going to remove this extra padding at the top. So I'm going to go into that column again, go into the spacing, and I'm going to cut this from 24 to 12 because I don't want a ton of extra spacing at the top of that. Now, the next thing I want to do is I'm going to make myself a quick logo over here. I'm going to remove this image, and I'm going to make myself a logo type just with some text. I'm calling this newsletter Major Scales. So we'll type in M-A-J-O-R. Scales, and I'm going to put a period there so I have like a full octaves worth of keys. And now I'm going to make this text bigger. I'm going to use another serif font, and I'm going to make that bold and chunk this up to bigger than my H1, so at least 32 Yeah, I'll do 32. That looks great. And now I'm going to color this like the keys on a keyboard. All right, so now I have a little logo for my page, all done just with text. Again, moving quickly so I can test my idea. Next up, I want to fill in the content of my page. And it's important that I clearly communicate what someone will get when they sign up, because I want to see how many people sign up when I share it on social media or directly with my friends or in forums for other people who are interested in learning piano. It's got to be clear. It's got to get to the point. So my headline is going to be, have 5 minutes a day and want to learn to play piano? It's going to ask that question. And one of the reasons I really love Playfair is because of this beautiful ampersand. So that's my headline. Hopefully that teases people, entices them into paying attention. Now I'm going to add my some more detail to what I'm going to be providing. And it's important that I share who it's for, what I'm going to be providing, and how frequently. Let's take a look. Who it's for. Budding musicians, what is the value that they're going to get? They're going to learn to play piano one day at a time. How often or how frequently am I going to be emailing them? Every week. And what specifically can they expect to get? Simple sheet music to help build skills, tips from piano teachers and other players, and piano pieces to inspire you. Next, let's spend a little time on our form. And the only change I'm going to make here are in the headline and the button copy. So I'm changing my headline to read, sign up and you'll get the first lesson right away. I'm going to hook this up to auto welcome campaign. So when people sign up, they immediately get an email with their first lesson. And I've changed the button call to action to start learning, to connect back with that value of learning to play the piano that we've been talking about. One last thing here is I'm going to chunk up the size. I'll put that to like 20. So it's a big juicy button. Now I'll look at my preview. That's looking pretty solid. Well, you could go in here and update your social links if you already have social links for a project. I'm going to assume that I don't because I'm just testing this idea out. So I'm going to delete that row out. The last thing I'm going to do is customize my page path and some of the social share stuff. So I'm going to go to settings. I'm going to change my page path to major scales. So my link is that customizes the URL people will see in their browser. It makes it easier for them to understand. And then I'm going to set some social sharing options. My page title is going to be Learn Piano in 5 minutes a Day. And the page description is going to read, the Major Scales newsletter gives free quick piano lessons. Last thing, I'm going to add an image, a social share image. I'm going to use the image gallery. I'll look for piano. And I'm just going to use this image. This is the image that will show up on social media when people share links to my page. All right. So that, I just got to title the landing page. I'm going to call it Major Scales. I'll save and exit. I'm just going to publish this page. Now I click on the link here and boom, it's live. It's ready for me to share out into the world and see what people think. Good luck. And if you make a page of your own, please share it in the comments for this video. I'd love to see it. See ya.